السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you the daily nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah, we present to you lesson number 1947, 22nd of Sha'ban. It was on the 22nd of Sha'ban, 598 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 2nd of September, 1192. Salahuddin Ayyubi Rahimahullah and Richard the Lionheart signed the treaty known as the Treaty of Ramallah. Ramla is a place there in Palestine. After the failure of the third campaign of the Crusaders, they wanted to take over Palestine, Majrul Aqsa, everything. And remember, they tried their level best. So we must remember from the year that was from 1099 to 1187, they had control and then they lost control. So therefore, now we must remember they had to sign this treaty. So this treaty made provision for the Christians to perform the pilgrimage to Baitul Muqaddas and to Jerusalem, because they also believe, remember, it's a holy place, the place of the birth of Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, peace be upon him. Nabi Isa alayhi salam's Mubarak name is mentioned 25 times in the Noble Quran. Sayyidah Maryam radiallahu anha, her honorable name mentioned 34 times in the Noble Quran. Chapter 19 dedicated to Sayyidah Maryam radiallahu anha. So without any fear, just as it allowed the Crusaders to govern the Syrian coast from Arsuf to Jaffa, so it shows this was how they did. And if you look at it, therefore the West, they called him Salahuddin, Saladin the Just. Even the way he's buried there opposite the Umayyad Masjid, you will find that lo and behold, a plague was sent from the German government and they put there Saladin the Just. And he just lived for 55 years, and lo and behold, the legacy he left behind, 17 sons, one daughter, and he decimated, destroyed the Christians and the Crusaders. So no, never can any person write the history of Islam without mentioning this great person's name, Salahuddin Ayyubi al-Kurdi. This is all Almighty Allah's favor. He takes work from whoever he wants. The person never saw Makkah Mukarramah, never saw Medina Munawwara, never performed Umrah or Hajj. And he would hardly smile when people ask him, why don't you smile? So he used to say, what is there for me to smile when our Mubarak blessed lands are under occupation? Does this not resonate with us? Look at Palestine under occupation, and by the Jews, the Zionists. Look at Syria under occupation, and that is by the Alawi Kuffar Shia regime. Look at Kashmir and India. So you must remember, so many places the Muslims now are being treated as second, third, fourth class. The Rohingya Muslims, they don't even know which country they belong to. We all know they belong to Myanmar and Burma, but you see the condition. United Nations said the most oppressed people on this earth. When they are taken to Bangladesh, then they are thrown out from there. Then they land up in India. So imagine all this happening. Where are the Muslim countries? Where is the Muslim Ummah? So therefore, we should cry. We should beg, petition Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. Ya Allah, these people, the Mazlumin, the oppressed of this Ummah, only you can have mercy on them, Ya Allah. This Ummah, by and large, has already forgotten them. And we all, majority of us, live in our own cocoon, khana, pina, sona. We are only worried of our own eating, drinking, sleeping and comfort, and oblivious of the plight of the Ummah. May Almighty Allah have mercy on all of us. وَأَدْخِلْنَا فِي رَحْمَتِكْ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Include us in your special mercy, O Allah, whilst you are the most merciful one to show mercy. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Salaamu Alaikum wa rahmatullah.